So as we know that this Malaysia have been announced that the the SARS-CoV-2 strain in Malaysia actually is strain B, and then they have another strain C and also the A, and then the most virulence I think is from America is AA2, which is more aggressive, it said. So by today, actually, I would like to share with you the thing is new, maybe. But today, I would like to analyze the SARS-CoV-2 by using the data that have been deposited to the NCBI. So means this is the simulation data analysis of COVID-19 disease. So we like to see that. Where's the strain of Wuhan strain and the other strain that we can found in the database. So the benefit of this study actually of this running actually we can apply to the new strain if we have that. So let's check it out. This is the oldest strain that I've been collect from the database. You can see all the strain of the COVID-19. This is the genome of COVID-19 that have been sequenced around the world. So we are going to analyze all these things in for the comparative genomics, so we can classify the genotyping of the COVID of the SARS-CoV-2. Analysis of comparative genomics, I will using the KISSNIP, Cas9-3, which is there will analyze looking for the SNP-based comparative genomic. And then let's start the analysis, and then we can see the result after the analysis done. So go ahead. So it's starting the analysis. So after this we are go through the phylogenetic tree that generate from this analysis. This is the generate of the data that have been done. So you can see that is 99% is similar. So we can see that the below this is the strain is from the bat before. So I will show you clearly after this what actually how we make up all this strain. Actually we can do a difference topo. For example, this one in the analysis, so we can see that more clearly about the strain, and then we can interpret actually what actually relation and evolution happen for this COVID causes disease and how actually transmission. But I believe that once everything is okay, we can do the analysis further, then make a publication in the future. So this is the simulation of data analysis. It's faster, and then they can generate a lot of things. Thank you for watching this video. Yeah, that is the way how we are going to analyze the COVID-19. So as we know that this Malaysia have been announced that the SARS-CoV-2 strain in Malaysia actually is strain B, and then they have another strain C and also the A. And then the most virulence, I think, is from America is AA2, which is more aggressive, he said. So this is how actually they are doing the analysis, and I believe that it can be happen the analysis here, and then it can make good research in the future. So how long we are taking to analyze this one? Actually, for this one, from the early part, for bioinformatic analysis, it will take around 24 hours. But the most crucial thing is during the alignment of the genome of the SARS-CoV-2. Why? The reason why we are going to handle the 30 KB size of genome, but we would like to compare with 100 genome. So that's why they are become similar with the one human genome analysis. So this is very difficult for us, and then during the alignment actually is very heavy, so we need the high performance computer to running all that thing. So thank you watching this video. Maybe you have a question, you can ask, and then I will explain through the comment. Check it out.